Thanks for watching my video today. Let's do another integral, definite integral, as using a Feynman technique, okay? Or with a square. Differentiation under the integral sign also, okay? So let's prove that the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative x sine ax upon x dx is inverse tangent of a, okay? Inverse tangent of a, then is the perimeter a. Now let I of a is equal to integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative x sine ax upon x dx. This is what we call parameterized, okay? So this integral depend on a, okay? If you put a equal to 1, 2, 3, then you're getting here, right? So now since we parameterize it already, so then is our parameter is a, right? So we are going to differentiate with respect to a. Then we have I prime of a, meaning differentiating this I of a with respect to a, okay? Then is the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative x upon x. According to Leibniz rule, if you differentiate or integral under the integral sign, then the differentiation, the derivative will be the partial derivative, okay? Then is del by del a of sine ax dx, okay? So I prime of a is integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative x, and differentiation of sine ax is nothing but cos, right? Cos ax, and differentiation of ax is just x upon x dx. Yeah, we differentiate with respect to a, okay? So these two can get cancelled out now. Then you get integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative x cos ax dx, okay? Now in the previous we proved that this integral is nothing but the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative ax cos bx dx is a upon a square plus b square. Here if you put a equal to 1 only, right? A equal to 1 and this b equal to a, okay? Then you get I prime of a is 1 upon 1 plus a square, right? Now in this is nothing but 1 upon 1 plus a square is nothing but the derivative of our original integral. So in order to get our original integral, this one, we are going to integrate back again with respect to a, okay? Now integrating with respect to a again, then what do we get? Okay, now if you integrate with respect to a, then you get integration of I prime of a dA is nothing but integration of 1 over 1 upon 1 plus a squared dA. And we know that integration of 1 over 1 plus a squared dA is nothing but tan inverse of a, right? Then is the very basic, okay? The integral representation of inverse tangent, okay? So tan inverse of a. And this is indefinite integral, so we are going to, don't forget the integration constant, okay? Constant of integration. Now I prime of a, if you integrate I prime of a, then you get I of a, right? Which is equal to tan inverse of a plus c. Why we get I integration of I prime of a dA, why we get I of a is here I prime of a dA. We know that I prime of a is nothing but differentiation with respect to a, right? dA. Okay. So something like these two can get cancelled. So you'll get integration of d of I of a. This is nothing but I of a. Right? It's something like that. Now, so I of a. So here, or I of a is nothing but or definite integral, right? It is not indefinite. So, but we get I of a is indefinite integral, right? Where we have constant c. Why we have constant c? Because our integration or integral is indefinite integral, right? But our I of a is nothing but definite integral, so we are trying to find out this constant c, okay? What is c? What is this c? So to find c, put a equal to 0, right? Then c equal to 0. How is that? If you put a equal to 0 here, sine 0 is what? 0, right? So they mean this is 0. And then tan 0 is 0, right? Tan inverse of 0 is 0, right? I of A is nothing but this one. If you put A equal to 0, sine 0 is 0, right? Sine 0 is 0 equal to tan inverse of 0 is nothing but 0 plus C. So you get, then what do you get? You get C equal to 0, right? So, or I of A is nothing but tan inverse of A. So I of A is nothing but this one, right? Therefore, integral from 0 to infinity of e to the negative x sine x upon x dx is tan inverse of A. That's it. Okay?